Hey kids, welcome to Kids View. So it's a little bit different today. I'm here in the Kids View room where we always have Kids Church, and you guys are probably at home, maybe even in your pajamas. So it's kind of different, but you know you can feel Jesus anywhere. You can feel him here when we have Kids View and we do our worship songs and Brother Conlon gives us the lesson and we feel the presence of God and it's so awesome. But then we can feel him at home or in our cars. Any place, any time that we pray and worship him, we can feel his presence. So today we're going to have a Kids View session, and we're going to sing some action songs and give you big ideas, and maybe your parents are watching, and it's going to be a great time. So let's get started.
Here in the valley of my soul, when I am lost and all alone, through the shadows I can see, your love is chasing after me. You cross the canyons of my fears, over the chasing after me. No mountain higher, no river wider, my heart may wander, your love will never stop chasing after me. Your love will never stop, never stop, never stop. Your love will never stop chasing after me. Your love will never stop, never stop.
Hey guys, it's time for the big idea. Today's big idea is God can't sleep. Now say it with me. God can't sleep.
Nope, God can't sleep. He is always awake. He is always with us. So let's do our scripture. Our scripture this morning is Psalms 121, 4. It says, "Indeed, he who watches over Israel never slumbers or sleeps." That means Jesus, God, he never sleeps. He's the one who's watching over Israel. So let's say it again. "Indeed, he who watches over Israel never slumbers or sleeps." Psalms 121, 4.
Hello, boys and girls. I'm so glad that you've joined me again today. We've got another lesson of what God can't do. Today's lesson is God can't sleep. Now, how many of y'all have ever tried to stay awake all night long? I have. And it's been so hard, but I can remember around Christmas time. You see all these gifts behind me. I can remember that I would try and stay awake all night long to see if I could see Santa Claus. Because my mom would tell me that our gifts would be here on Christmas Day, that Santa Claus would bring us our gifts when we were little kids. And so I wanted to see if Santa Claus was real. And I can remember trying to stay awake all night long. And a lot of times I almost made it. But somewhere about 5 or 6 in the morning, I would drift off to sleep. And then when I woke up, I would have missed Santa Claus coming because gifts would be around the tree. Now, there were always gifts around the tree around Christmas time, but then there were special gifts that were only there whenever I woke up. Those gifts were supposedly brought to me by Santa Claus. Now, I don't know if you still believe in Santa Claus. I don't know if you've stayed awake all night long and tried to catch Santa Claus sneaking into your house. Maybe you've done it. Maybe you've seen Santa Claus. I don't know, but I've never seen Santa Claus, so I don't think Santa Claus is real. But boys and girls, I do know that Jesus is real. Now, our scripture today that we read was Psalms 121:4. It says, "Indeed, he who watches over Israel never slumbers nor sleeps." That means that God does not sleep. He doesn't have to have sleep like me or you. Now, me and you, even if we stayed up all night long, even if we then turned around and stayed up all day long, we would be extremely tired. We would get so tired that we would barely be able to keep our eyes open. We would be so tired that we would become delirious and we would start laughing and our body would start acting funny because our body requires sleep. Not God. He never slumbers nor sleep. Do you know what he's doing? He's always watching over us. That means because he doesn't sleep and he's watching over us that we can sleep. We can rest because we know that Jesus is taking care of us while we sleep. Now, I know that sometimes we get scared to go to sleep at night. We go into our room and we shut the door and it's dark or maybe we leave the door open so we can let some light on. But we lay in the bed and we think, oh no, what if something gets me? Oh no, there's something maybe under my bed. What if something jumps out of the closet? Do you know, I thought that all the time when I was a little boy. And guess what? Nothing ever jumped out of my closet. Nothing ever climbed out from under my bed because it was only my imagination playing tricks on me. boys and girls, Jesus watches over us each and every night. And so when we're laying in our bed and we're scared and we're fearful and we close our eyes because it's dark, we can pray. We can say, Jesus, watch over me. Jesus, I know you're right there. And guess what, boys and girls? He is right there beside of you. You can't see him physically. You may not even be able to hear him. You may not even be able to feel him. But he's right there with you each and every night, watching over you. Whether you go to school, whether you're playing outside with the other boys and girls, Jesus is right there with you each and every day, watching over us. Boys and girls, I am so thankful that we have a God like we do that never slumbers nor sleep. That we have a God that's always watching out for you and I. I want us just to take a few moments and let's thank him for being a God who never sleeps and is always watching over us. Can we do that right now? Jesus, thank you, God, that we serve someone that never slumbers nor sleeps. You always watch over us. You're always there, God, protecting us from harm. Jesus, I ask that you reach down in every single one of our children's homes and you give them peace, that you let them know that you are right there by their side each and every day. Lord, we love you so much and we want to thank you, God, today. Because of what you've done in our lives, Lord, you have forgiven us, God. You have filled us with your Spirit, the gift of the Holy Ghost. We're so thankful that we know who you are. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say amen. Now let's raise our hands as high as we can and say, Jesus, I love you so very much. Now give him a bear hug and squeeze him tight. Ugh. I will see you one day again very soon. I love you, boys and girls. Bye-bye.
Okay, guys, we are so glad that you joined us today for this service. We love you. We miss you. And the KidsView team, we are thinking about you and we are praying for you and your families. Just remember that God is with you during this time. You don't have to be afraid. We love y'all so much. Bye, guys.